Have you ever heard the story of the boy who cried wolf? If you haven't, here's how it goes. A boy is given the responsibility to watch over his family sheep. He is told that if he sees a wolf, he should cry out and help will come. Day after day, he keeps calling out that there is a wolf to get people's attention or to play a joke. Each time, they come to help, but there is no wolf. One day, he actually sees a real wolf, and he cries out truthfully, but this time, everyone thinks he's trying to play a trick on them again, so they don't come to help. Later, he is found at the top of a hill weeping because a wolf ate all the sheep. Now imagine an opposite version of that story, where there is a boy keeping watch over his family's sheep, and he sees a wolf, but does not cry out, because he believes he can handle it on his own. He thinks that if he cries wolf right away, his family and village might think he's weak and incapable. But if he doesn't cry wolf at all, or waits too long, he may lose some or all of the sheep. Hi, my name is Luke Williams, and I believe that it's important to be able to ask for help when you need it, even if you are worried that you might look incapable or you think that you have waited too long to ask for support. During the summer, as I was preparing to enter eighth grade, my parents and I sat down to go over my summer homework. I told them that I felt confident that I could finish my work on my own without much help or support from them. I was able to complete all my work by the deadlines, so I convinced my parents that during my final year in middle school, I should have more independence with my schoolwork and that they could trust I would maintain good grades. However, fairly early on during the first semester, I found myself procrastinating on my homework and not putting forth my best effort in class. Soon, my grades began to reflect my lack of effort. Since my parents had agreed to let me manage my work on my own, they were not aware of how quickly things started to snowball. And although the work itself was not super challenging, the fact that it was piling up became overwhelming. I felt nervous and ashamed that I had let things get so out of hand. My parents have always been very supportive and helped me with anything I ever needed. So they reasonably assumed that if I wasn't asking for help, everything was going fine and I was getting all my work done. It made it easier to keep this under the radar because I continued to do well in other aspects of my life. I helped around the house, contributed to the success of my sports teams, and overall made good decisions inside and outside of school. However, as you can imagine, this could not go on forever. When my parents sat down with me to look at my progress, they were surprised and confused. I felt like they were disappointed in me because I was disappointed in myself. Although they were upset, we talked about what had happened and why, and they worked with me on reaching out to my teachers to set up meetings and figure out how I could get back on track with my assignments and get my grades to where I wanted them to be. It was hard facing my teachers and acknowledging that I had made mistakes, but they were also very supportive and encouraged me. They assured me that it was not too late, and that if I gave my best effort, I would be able to have a successful semester that I could be proud of. In the Bible, Matthew 7:7 states, "Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you." Sometimes when God puts you in a situation, he wants you to ask for help. God does not expect us to be able to handle everything that comes our way alone. Believing that we must always be independent can lead to failure. Sometimes God helps us by doing things himself, by giving us inner strength or guidance, and sometimes God helps us through other people, like our parents, siblings, and friends. We must never be afraid to get help for big decisions from others. We have all heard stories of kids in the news, or maybe even know someone personally, who has felt overwhelmed and they think they can handle everything on their own, so they don't cry wolf. And the pressure gets to be too much, and their lives fall apart in one way or another. Trying to handle stress and isolation can have devastating consequences. I can imagine that if I kept hiding my secret longer or the stakes were higher, like I was a junior in high school thinking about applying to college, how serious the situation could have been. You can begin to understand how some students wind up desperate to find a way out and might hurt themselves. Maybe if they had cried wolf and reached out for help, their family and community could have been there to support them through their difficult times. Our eighth grade class is anxiously awaiting to see where we might be going to high school next year, where the challenges of balancing academics, athletics, and other extracurricular activities will undoubtedly be much greater than what we face here in middle school. We will need to ask for help over and over again, but no matter our age, we need to remember to set realistic goals for ourselves and try our best, and knowing when to cry wolf will be critical and consider the most important sheep of all, You. Thank you.